Okay, welcome back. We are starting the first chapter of the second portion of the game, which I like to call the Walhart or Walmart portion. The first portion is Gangrel of Plegia, and this next portion is all about Walhart of Valm. So, yeah. And this level is actually pretty tough. Every single unit is either on a horse or in armor. So, yeah, we have to be very careful. Ooh, wait, hold on. Sully, I have a present for you. It's a hammer. That's gonna definitely come in handy in this level. Crap, I don't like the look of how this side's gonna handle it. None of these guys are really that defensive. Oh well, we're just gonna have to play and see what happens. So yeah, this is just some general who's all like, I claim this land in the name of Walhart the Conqueror, and kneel before us, because we're all powerful and stuff. And then he kills this random villager. So yeah, first like, what? Another war, dude? And he's like, well, here's what I want our Elise to stand for. We need to stand for peace. And we must stand against evil in all its forms. So that's what we're gonna do. Alright, Donald. You go here. Oh, you have a beast killer. Interesting. You could have been more helpful than I thought. Or, I mean, if someone else had that. Thank you so much for your help, Donnie. That helped so much. Oh well, if it didn't help, whatever. You still got experience from it. That's all that matters. Okay. And Sully... Oh, you didn't even need your hammer! Well, the hammer one-shots the knights, so we should definitely go with that. It's not like he was going to do any damage to you anyway, but still. And this is why Sully is awesome as a Wyvern Rider. Okay, now for this side. Me, Krom, Sumia, with her steel lance, and Gregor. And she'll dance for Gregor just to get some experience. Church, I don't plan on using her, but you can stand by me if you'd like, with your hammer. No, not with your hammer, with your steel axe. Kellum, go up here. Lyssa, go next to Kellum. And Gaius, go next to Sumia. With your steel sword. Alright, bring it on. Haha, you missed. With a 69% chance. Wow, 21% crit. I think I'm helping out with that, because he's standing next to me. And Krom likes me. yeah. So. And no, even with that speed wing I gave Gregor, he still can't attack twice. And this is a paladin. That's the advanced form of a cavalier. So, paladins are pretty good. Do I have any plans to have a paladin? I didn't even think about that. I usually have at least one every time. I'm looking at my chart of people now, and no, I don't plan on having a paladin at all. Weird. They're some of the best units, in my opinion. Okay. So, this looks like trouble. Even though I don't want to use Church in the long run, I might have to use her in this battle just to help out. Maybe. Maybe. Gaius. Can you kill this guy? You can. He'll do 14 damage to you, though. Gregor can't even kill this guy. He'll miss by one. Well, you have Olivia next to you. I'll just have her dance for you, I guess. Oh, never mind. I got a dual strike. So, thank you, me. You were very helpful. I'm still gonna have her dance for Gregor, though. Trade the hammer? No one else can use axes except Sully right now. So, no one else would really use it. Oh, Gregor can two-shot this guy. Let's do that. This guy probably won't go for Gregor next turn. But that's fine. And I can't kill this guy because I don't attack twice. Let's use an L Thunder. Ignis activated! That's a 25. See, it adds half of whichever skill I wasn't using. So wait, that was gonna do 19, right? Why did it only add 6? Half of 19 is at least 9. Wait, it was gonna do 17? I don't remember how much it was gonna do. But it should have added 9 to my attack, because I'm using magic, so it adds half of my strength skill to that attack. Yeah, that's how it works. Alright, guys, you finish off this guy. Hooray, another Master Seal. I so don't need more of... I so need tons more of those. I'll just have Sumia kill this guy, I guess. Miss. Har har. Not really, but that's fine. Crom stand here? I know he probably could kill that cavalier, but I'd rather Gregor kill him for experience. I probably should have healed Crom before I made him walk there, because those are the two people I was going to heal. Actually, crap. Crom should have walked up. Not that way. Crap. So here's what's gonna happen. Church is just gonna stand right here with her hammer. So is Sully. That is all we're gonna do this turn. I'm not gonna advance any of these people forward. That would be a death trap. Can Muriel kill this guy over here? Yeah, Muriel can kill this guy over here. I'll do that. Have I been streaming for long? Yes, I have. But that's okay. I am uploading this to YouTube at someday in my life. So, you'll see it eventually. Unless, I guess you have to waste another physic. But that's okay. We have tons of them. Oh, I didn't think that through. Well, Kellum wouldn't be able to reach him anyway. Darn. Whoops. Okay, well, Kellum, you walk over here, I guess. I'm kind of afraid for Gregor now. Can either of these... Oh, neither of these knights can even reach him. Never mind, we're fine. And Donald, equip your javelin, just in case someone wants to try to attack you. Oh, that missed. Thank you. Well, it wouldn't have mattered. Because the knight didn't die, so he's occupying the space that would need to be stood in order for him to get attacked. There's not a whole lot of conversation that goes on in my Fire Emblem streams, I've noticed. Does no one know what to say, or... Oh. And I have a strong feeling Charge is getting tons of experience. Yep, they're all gonna attack her. And she's gonna just kill all of them. Unless she dies herself. Which is... Looks like it's gonna be possible that that's gonna happen. That's not good. I didn't really want her to die. I know I don't have plans to use her, but still... Tully, it's great that you killed that guy, but... Oh... I don't know... I'm definitely worried about Church. Yeah, she's gonna die. I think I'm gonna restart this level. Yep, I shouldn't have done that. Yes, I know I wasn't planning on using her, but sorry, not doing it. I could easily have avoided that. Restarting, I'm gonna do the exact same strategy except at the point where I was just at, move Crom upwards in the spot Church was standing in. I don't need to watch this scene again. Okay. Gregor was here. Sumia. Wait. Crom was here. Sumia was here with her steel lance. Gaius was here. Olivia was here, danced for Gregor. On the bright side, that was a better level up you got than the first time I played through, so good job, Muriel. And stop! Hammer time!
Damn nuisance.
Alright, okay. Note to self, I need Kellen to be here, Church to be here, Lyssa to be here. Okay, there we go. That's more like it. Didn't happen last time. Hey, interesting. This is going better than last time already. You wonder if you'll see an actual death. What? You mean what just happened didn't count? Or you mean a death where I actually keep it and keep going? That's unlikely. I'm trying to do a no-death run. And some of you might think, well, you've already failed then. Well, that's not how Fire Emblem games work. So, alright, Crom, do not do anything except walk here. And keep your falchion, yes, not the rapier. I know the rapier will be good against all these armor guys, but it would not be smart for you to kill every single one that approaches you, because then you'll just get to keep getting hit by more and more and more. Okay. This is a little bit of a different situation, because the paladin's over here now. Okay, Elephander would have done 16. That's what... 16 plus 9 is 25. That's how that happened last time. I'm pretty sure Gregor can't do 14. He can do 8. And then Olivia can dance for him and you can kill it in second turn. Let's do that. Chance. I don't know if I want to take the risk. Let's heal him before I do that, just in case. I was gonna heal him afterwards, but you never know. I missed with 96% chance. You all saw it. Alright, I didn't miss. Okay. Can these guys even reach us? These guys can't even reach us, except for Sumia. They can reach Sumia, that's it. So I don't really need to worry too much about them. Let's kill this guy with Sumia. Oh, I should put guys next to her before doing that. Oh well. Oh, apparently he can reach Gaius now. Okay. That's fine. I'll have him stand here. Church is the only one. Church and Sully. And they're gonna just stand where they are. Actually, no. Church will stand here. Oh, Callum also hasn't moved. But there's no one he can heal right now. No, never mind. He can heal Crom. Yeah. Let's do that. Someone will probably attack him with a javelin, but it's Kellum. He'll be fine. And all that's left is Sully, and she doesn't need to move, so begin. Please don't kill this guy. Please don't kill this guy. Thank you. Thank you for not killing him. Because if that guy had been killed, this knight right here would have attacked Gaius instead of Sumia there. So in situations like that, it's better to hope for not getting a dual strike. And I never thought I'd have to worry about Crom, but it looks like I might actually have to. Because of what I just said a second ago. Sully's gonna make sure everyone who attacks him is gonna die, because Sully's always gonna get a stupid dual strike. Yep, every time. Only two more hits and Crom's dead. And then I have to restart the level, whether I want to or not. I'll speed through this battle. Oh, never mind. Thank you so much, Sully! This is exactly what happened to Church. Exactly. There's at least three more Cavaliers that can attack him. So, yeah, Crom's in trouble. Well, you learned Aether. Congratulations. Too bad it's not going to help you survive this attack.
I'm right here.
Yep, that's the end of that. You have to try again. Because if Crom dies, it's game over. I'll show you what happens in case you wanted to know.